In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Our Father and our God, we want to bless and magnify your holy name. Jehovah God, we want to give you all the glory, all the honor, all the praises, all adoration. You say, blessed be your name, Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Holy Father, as we look into your word, this our Lord, we invite the Holy Spirit, a great teacher, to come and be in attendance to teach us, to make us to know what we need to know and to practicalize in our life. That at the end, your name will be glorified in life in Jesus. And this is what we study, Lord, will be a blessing to us, Lord Jesus. But anyone who has sinned against you, by what we say, what we do, what we do, even among all our partners and all those who will listen to this word, in one way or the other, Father, bless them and bless the work of our hand. Deliver us from coronavirus, from sickness, from disease. You brought us to this country to bless us wherever we are. Bless us and enlarge our cause. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Bless all our brothers and sisters, our partners, our friends, all our associates, our friends we pray for. May your hand of blessing rest upon us. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We're going to be looking at 1 Kings chapter 22. Deceived by false prophets. A lesson for us all. You see, as children of God, there is one thing we must learn. Everybody that prophesies in God's name don't represent God. Because somebody says, I'm a pastor, I'm a priest, I'm that, I'm this, I'm a pope, whatever name they be, whatever the bishop, G.O., whatever you call them, don't let me represent God. Here is Ahab. He was a man that doesn't really have interest in God, but he has a friend, Jehoshaphat, who have a heart after God. Jehoshaphat went to visit Ahab, and as he got there, as a king, he told him about his problem. He said, here's my problem. What do you think I should do? And while they were discussing that problem, they started talking on solution. Most people want to hear from God. Even people that don't know God, they believe there is no God. They want to hear from God. They start by that. Most people want to hear from God, but they don't want to do God's will. Divine Grace International Ministries' goal is to prepare families that hear God's voice and do God's will. That's our goal. To make sure you know God yourself and be able to serve him well and able to do it. So at the end, God will take the glory and your life will be a lesson. It is a very important lesson for us to learn here today about Jehoshaphat and Ahab and false prophets. There are so many false prophets today. There are many. There are so many so-called pastors who are not pastors at all. They are there for their profit, for what they are going to get. They serve the God of their bellies. May God make us to know him and also serve the God of our belly in Jesus' name. Mm-hmm. Brothers and sisters, without wasting time, let us go to the Bible passage we are going to read today. 1 Kings chapter 22. For 3 years, there was no war between Aram and Israel. Then, during the 3rd year, King Jehoshaphat of Judah went to visit King Ahab of Israel. During the visit, the king of Israel said to his officials, do you realize that the town of Ramoth Gilead belongs to us? And yet, we have done nothing to recapture it from the king of Aram. Then he turned to Jehoshaphat and said, will you join me in battle to recover Ramoth Gilead? Jehoshaphat replied to the king of Israel, why not? Of course, you and I are as one. My people are your people. My troop are your troop. And my horses are your horses. Then Jehoshaphat added, but first, let's find out what the Lord says. May God bless the word in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It is very good to have a good friend. Every now and then we're going to have challenges. We're going to have problems. It's not if we are going to have problems, it's only when. You know, when you have a problem, either as a young girl, you're looking for a husband, or as a young man, you're looking for a wife, or you're looking for a job, or maybe God may be calling you to become a pastor, or you want to do any career. The first thing you do you ask God? Or do you ask your friend, how much money are you making? How many hours do you work? Your friend wants to tell you what you should do, but that's not the wise choice. The wise choice from this lesson is that King Ahab brought a problem to his friend, Jehoshaphat, the king of Judah. And he said, we want to reclaim our land. You know, there's a problem. There are things you think they are yours. Might be a job, a girl, a man, career, promotion. But you ask yourself, somebody, what can I do to get this thing that belongs to me? The sad part of it is that Jehoshaphat, or the good part of it was Jehoshaphat was a good man, but the sad part that King Ahab was not a good man. Was not a godly man at all. He was a very, very evil man. His heart was not in God at all. What God is looking at is our heart. Brothers and sisters, listen to me, please. Is your heart in God? Do you see to God, do God's will? Or are you after what you can gain? As I always say, this world does not belong to us. If it's only in this world we have hope, we are formed and miserable. As I always say all the time, you serve the Lord well, and you leave the rest to God. God knows how to take care of you. When you truly serve God, God can join you and make a life better for you, or God can bless you. I always say, when things seem hard for me, that's the more reason I want to be close to God, and God always turn my life around. God can do the same thing for you. What do you have to do? Read your Bible very well. But Joseph has said, we want to go to war. Ahab said, we want to go to war. Both of them agree, but Joseph has said, no, before we go to war, let us ask from God if God wants us to go to war. Do you think your house is my house? Your money is my money? Yeah, this is that. We are friends. We are brothers from the same village. But do you ever ask God, shall I join forces with this man or this woman? Verse 4. Then he turned to Joseph and asked, will you join me in battle to recover Ramoth Gilead? Joseph replied to the king of Israel, why not? Of course, you and I are one. My troop are your troop, and my horses are your horses. You see that one? It's good to have a friend who believes that you are one in terms of need. You know, sometimes when you have a need, I've told you guys over and over, your friend will tend to run away from you, but it's very sad. That's not a true friend. A true friend is supposed to be with you when you have a need. Even your brother will run away. That's what the Bible said. Proverbs said, a person that is poor will be running to his brother will be running away from him. Verse 6. So the king of Israel summoned the prophets, about 400 of them. Listen, 400 prophets. As I always say, multitude does not mean nothing in the sight of God. I just many pastors say, we're the largest church in America. We're the largest church in the world. We have this big land. We have this big church. God does not interested in that, for heaven's sake. What your God is looking at is your heart. The heart of people that come to church, what you are teaching them. There are so many big churches here in America where we are, and where this world is coming to, especially in Dallas, Texas, where this world is coming to you, and from all our partners around the United States, around the world. There are so many big churches in your town, in your country, in your various states. But does it mean they are serving God? They are not. So there are 400 prophets. They were large prophets. There were a lot of prophets. And he asked them, should I go to war against Ramoth Gilead or hold back? You know, the gods, people that serve the gods of their belly. There are so many pastors who serve the gods of their bellies. There are so many priests, so many prophets, so many Jew, so many leaders. They are not actually called by God. They are only there for the money they are going to get, for the God of their prophet, for the God of their money, for what they can get for themselves. These prophets are not serving the Lord. You know what they are there for? For what they can get. Here is the king. If we serve the king, if we are loyal to the president, as he's going to do in America, around the whole world, even in your own country, if we speak well of the president, even if the president is doing bad things, we know this president is not a man of God. This president is a bad person. Everybody is obvious that. Because to be on his good book, oh, he's a nice man, he's a nice woman, oh, we just have to pray for him, he's just a newborn again Christian, or even if he's not a Christian, he's a good man, even though he worships idol, he's a good man. Before, you used to condemn this man. You used to speak bad, ill of this man. All of a sudden, he's a good man. Oh, yeah, we should support him because he's giving you money, he's giving you privileges, and it's making your life better for you. He's a good man to you. Who are you going to serve? The gods of your belly or the Almighty God? Apostle Peter said, we'd rather serve God than man. We're not going to serve tables. We're not going to serve the God of our belly. We're going to devote ourselves to preaching, to teaching, and to exhorting people about the true living God. You know what happened? These 400 prophets, Ahab asked them, should I go to war? They are large prophets. They are majority. They all reply, yes, go right ahead. The Lord will give the king victory. Which Lord are they referring to? They don't know this God they are referring to. But Joseph asked, is there not also a prophet of the Lord here? We should ask him the same question. Here is a wise man. You know your pastor is not a true pastor. You know your bishop, your GO, all these men are not true men. You know what they are doing. You know their secret. How they are cheating, how they are stealing, how they are doing fornication, adultery, doing evil things, and how they are using every magic in the book to turn people to themselves to get money. But Joseph had recognized that these prophets are not true prophets of God. What did he say now? He said, is there not another true prophet of God here we can ask apart from these 400 men? King of Israel replied to Joseph, there is one more man who could consult for us, but I hate him. He never prophesies anything but trouble for me. His name is Micaiah, son of Imala. You see, when you tell people the truth, they never like you. When you tell people, depart from sin, fornication is bad, adultery is bad, cheating is bad, taking government money is bad, stealing from government office is bad. When you go to work, when you are doing bad things, it's bad. Oh, they don't like you. Oh, I don't like that pastor. He's always trying to condemn me. Nobody's above mistake. I'm only a human being. You shouldn't try to condemn me. You are working for the government. You are stealing the money. All those houses you are building, where do you get the money? All those cars you are riding, all these women you are carrying, even all these pastors, because you have the money right now, you think the money is yours. These 400 prophets are not men of God. They worship idol. But what happened? Here is Josaphat. He said, we need to hear from a true man of God who does not fear nobody, who have no respect, who must say the truth as it is. A holy man of God. Are you holy? Are you living for God in your place of work, in your family? Even if you go to a church, is your church actually teaching you the truth? Or they're just talking about money, get rich, give money, get promotion, give money, get husband, give money. They're not telling you about victory. They're not telling you about defeat. But the victory they have been promising you, they pray all this prayer that doesn't have no meaning. Joseph replied, that is not the way a king should talk. Let us hear what he has to say. You should not talk about a prophet like that. Let us hear what he has to say. So the king of Israel was not happy. He reluctantly called one of his officials and said, quick, bring Micaiah, son of Imala. What happened? They went. You know, people can try to convince you. You know, you just come to this work now. You just come to this family. You had this boyfriend. If he's touching you, if he's doing this one, don't hurt you. If they are stealing money, also steal money. That's what everybody is doing. Just follow what everybody is doing. You're a Christian. Just drink. Just smoke. Just have sex. Just fornicate. Just steal. Just tell lies. You don't have to study your book. Just pay the professor to make you to pass. When you're looking for a job, just bribe. That's what everybody is doing. At the end of the day, when you have problem, who do you consult? The God you never call upon when you have the success. Is it the God you are going to consult now when you're in trouble? May God help us in Jesus' name. Verse 10, King Ahab of Israel and King of Jehoshaphat of Judah dressed in their royal robes. That's what impressed this false prophet, this 400 prophets. We are sitting on the throne at the threshing floor near the gate of Samaria. All of Ahab prophets, they are Ahab prophet. You know, we have so many pastors today who belong to the president. Even the president is a sinner. He's not a Christian. Oh, that's our prophet. That's the prophet for this president. That's the pastor for this thing. Oh, I know the governor. I know the president. I'm going to the governor's office. I'm going to the presidency because you are going to collect bag of money. And when you go to television, you start talking good about that man, even though you know he's bad. You know he's killing people. He's sponsoring terrorism. He's doing evil things. He's having sex with so many women. He's stealing the nation's money, and he's doing so many wicked things. What do you have to know? Oh, he's just a young convert. He's a new Christian. We just have to pray for him. Even though he's not a Christian, he's a good man. There is no good man that will enter the kingdom of heaven. Only those who believe in Jesus Christ and live a righteous and holy life. May God help us in Jesus' name. Amen. All of Ahab's prophets were prophesying there in front of them. Then there is the king of Israel and the king of Judah. One of them, Zedekiah, son of Kenaana, made some iron horns and proclaim, this is what the Lord said. With these horns, you will gog the Arameans to death. You see, these are false prophets. They pray for you. They prophesy for you. They tell you this thing. Oh, you have this big horn, like this cow horn, like this big cow horn. They have it with this big iron. This is why you're going to defeat your enemy. They tell you all this trash. You're going to get a job. Next year, life is going to be better for you. Coming year, years ago. But year after year, what they are telling you is not good, because they're not telling you the truth. They are only giving you their imagination. And at the end of the day, all they're leading you to is sin and sin and sin. And all they're interested in is only your money. But because you are giving them this money now, they want to give you this false prophet. They want to give you this false hope, this false vision, this false dream. May God help us in Jesus' name. All of that prophets agree. Yes. You see, the 400 of them, we are going to agree. We don't want to offend the president. We don't want to offend the governor. We don't want to offend the local chairman. Whatever, if we offend him, we're not going to get the money. The money that was meant to develop the nation, to develop the schools, to develop the hospitals, to develop the street, to develop everything, is not being given to you as an individual. Individual is richer than the state. Is that not madness? And at the end of the day, everybody is poor. And these few people, because they're in government, because they call themselves pastor for the president, they think they are rich. They are riding most expensive car, dressed in gold. Their members are poor. These prophets who were prophesying for Ahab were very well to do. They had to always say what the king wants to hear so that the king can be happy with them. All of that prophets agree. Yes, they said, go up to Ramoth Gilead and be victorious, for the Lord will give the king victory. Be very careful what people are telling you in your business, in your school, in your marriage, in your career. Are they telling you the voice of God, or they want to tell you what you want to hear? I see a lot of people are doing so many businesses. You know you are stealing. People that are praying for you know you are stealing. Your so-called pastor know you are stealing. But they are only praying for you so that I can come and give them more. They are serving the gods of their belly. These are these false prophets. We have 400 of them. They all agree. Meanwhile, the messenger who went to get Micaiah said to him, look, all the prophets are prophesying victory for the king. Be sure that you agree with them and promise success to the king also. You see how he want to force you? Everybody is stealing. Everybody is cheating. Everybody is lying. Just follow everybody so that you will not be the odd man. You don't want to be the odd woman. You don't want to be the odd person. Are you like that? You want to be the odd person? It's better for you to be odd for God than to be committing sin with the sinners of this world and go to heaven. Brothers and sisters, for a moment, listen. Listen to me, please. Heaven is real. This world is not our home. I don't care how much money you have. I'm in the United States in America. I will compare. The people will say this is the best country in the world, but it's not. There are so much suffering in this land. A lot of people have been dying this month. A lot of well-to-do people, rich people, politicians. But you know what happened? When they die, everything they have, they leave it behind. But those people that don't know God, if you die, you die with everything you have. But if you know God, you live on. May God help us in Jesus' name. Verse 14. But Micaiah said, as surely as the Lord lives, I will always say what the Lord tell me to say. I love this man. I love him. I will always say what the Lord wants me to say. Are you always say what God wants you to say? Are you a pastor? Are you always say what God wants you to say? Are you a prophet? Are you a bishop? Are you a GO? Are you a priest? Are you always say what God wants you to say? Or you always say it to make people to be happy with you? Nobody likes bad news. Several times I told people bad news. They don't like it. I said, this is what God is telling me. One time I told the guy, I said, what you are praying for, God is not going to answer the prayer. This is what God is telling me. It's going to take almost 20 years for this thing to come to pass. Because what you're asking, God is not going to answer. God was about to answer the prayer. All of a sudden, the person would draw back. I said, sorry, God is not going to answer your prayer no more. Am I God to tell him that? It's what God is telling me. Initially, was he happy? Oh, that's not what I want to hear. Well, that is the truth. When I said the first time, you may be angry with me if you are there. Why will you say that as a pastor? It's really what God wants me to say, and I will tell you. I'm not going to tell you lies that will not benefit you. Today, that word I've said is still going on, and the word has not come to that word I said about 20 years. We're seeing this day. It may be longer than that one. When Micaiah arrived before the king, Ahab asked him, Micaiah, should we go to war against Ramoth Gilead, or should we hold back? Micaiah replied sarcastically, yes, go up and be victorious. For the Lord will give you, for the Lord will give the king victory. That's what the king wants to hear. The multitude I see are going to get victory. Is that what they are telling you? I join them to tell you. But the man know that this is not what the man was actually saying. Because when the man said, you want to go to war? Go ahead. You are going to get victory. That's what the other pastors are telling you. That's what the other prophets are telling you. That's what the other bishop are telling you. That's what the other Jew are telling you. Oh, you are going to get victory. That's what the politician want to hear. And as a pastor, you have to tell them what they want to hear so that they can give you the money. That's what you are looking for. But the king replied sharply, how many times must I demand that you speak only the truth to me when you speak for the Lord? The king knows this guy. This is a fearless guy. This is a guy who always says the truth. But the way he's saying it, it doesn't sound like the truth. Then Micah told him, in a vision, I saw all Israel scattered on the mountains like sheep without a shepherd. And the Lord said, their master has been killed. Send them home in peace. You see, this is what the Lord wants this man to hear. But because of his refusal, because of his stubbornness, he will not want to hear the truth. He wants to hear only the truth, only the victory, only sweet, sweet, sweet prayer. As I said, most people send prayer. When I hear, oh, God is going to bless you, God is going to give you wife, God is going to give you a husband, God is going to protect you, God is going to promote you, amen, amen, amen. Everybody say amen. Other prayer, other, they are circulating around the whole world. Nobody is going to say repent. Trust in God. Believe in Him. Have faith in Him. Turn away from sin. When you go to work, don't steal. If you're a government, don't steal money. Don't do prostitution. Don't do drugs. Don't do bad things. Trust the Lord. Serve Him faithfully. Have patience. Don't be in the haste to be rich. Nobody wants to hear that. Oh, you're going to get promotion. This year is your year. I promise you. I prophesy. By the name of God, I demand God. I command God. As if God is your messenger. As if God is your servant. I demand that God do it for you right now. No. God by fire. I call upon God by fire. Really? Who are you talking to? God is your servant? This man said, the king is going to die. Didn't I tell you? This is King Ahab now. King of Israel's claim to Jehoshaphat. He never prophesizes anything but trouble for me. You know, when you're a bad man, don't expect good results. If you think you're a bad man, you're a bad king, a bad governor, a bad local government chairman, a bad company director, a bad commissioner, a bad minister, a bad anything, you are stealing money, even a bad husband, a bad wife, you think God is going to bless you? Forget about it, my friend. God is not going to bless you. You want God to bless you? Brothers and sisters, I try to tell us the truth. May not be palatable. You may not like it, but the truth is what I'm called to say. And I have to tell you that the truth. If you like, I know most of you are coming here every week to hear this word of God. As you hear it and you do the will, may the Lord bless you. Bless your family. Bless your home. And may He give you the true blessing that belongs to you as you obey Him and do His will in Jesus' name. As I always say, it's not about money. I'm not looking for your money. I'm only telling the truth. If you do the truth, God will bless you. This world is not our home. May God help us in Jesus' name. Verse 19. When then Micaiah continued, listen to what the Lord says. I saw the Lord sitting on His throne with all the armies of heaven around Him, on His right and on His left. And the Lord said, who can entice Ahab to go into battle against Ramoth Gilead so he can be killed? You see, you have to be very careful how you want to pursue something. Because what may look at you like a success, because you're not serving the Lord, maybe you're done for. When all these false prophets are telling you this vision, this dream, oh, go, you're going to be successful. Marry this man. He's a rich guy. Go to this business. I always want to hear God's voice. Sometimes when I'm praying, I hear God talking to me. And I'll tell the person, this is what God is telling to me. Sometimes I just pray, I know the prayer is going to be answered. But sometimes when I pray, I hear another voice telling me, this is what is going to happen. When I want to tell the person, well, this is the truth I have to say. I tell the person, say, well, this is my concern. May God help us in Jesus' name. There's something I just pray, I say, don't worry, you are fine, relax, you don't have no problem. But there's sometimes I pray, I don't have easiness in my spirit. God is telling me, even what I'm asking Him, it's not His will. Because it's when you do God's will that God will do your will also. If you serve the Lord, God will bless you. But if you want to be on the side of the devil, don't look for God and don't ask God for bless you. May God help us in Jesus' name. There are many suggestions. And finally, a spirit approached the Lord and said, I can do it. So There are so many suggestions that how do we deceive Ahab to go to war? This was the Spirit of God not talking. How will you do this? The Lord asked. And the Spirit replied, I will go out and inspire all Ahab's prophets to speak lies. Have to be very careful who you listen to. Because there are lots of pastors who are not serving the Lord, who are stealing, who are cheating, who are homosexual, who are committing sexual relationship with young girls, with married women, who are going to married women houses and having sex with them. And when they come to church, they are praying for you. They are only praying curse. They are only praying demon spirits upon you. You have to be very careful the church you go to and who you listen to. I'm not telling you which church to go to, but be very careful who you listen to. Because after these people have committed all this abominable thing, they now have evil spirit. They are coming to prophesy on you. Then you're going to get into trouble. May God help us in Jesus' name. You will succeed, said the Lord. Go ahead and do it. Then God is now telling this spirit of God, go. One of the spirits that minister to God, the ministry spirit, say, go. You'll be able to do this by deceiving the prophet. So you see, the Lord has put a lying spirit in the mouths of all your prophets, for the Lord has pronounced your doom. You see, because these prophets are not serving the Lord, God blind their eyes. They could not see the truth. They are telling the man what he wants to hear. But instead of him to listen to what this other true prophet was telling him, he was getting angry with the man. He would have said, well, Micaiah, he does this. Why is the Lord angry with me? What can I do? What do you advise we should do? The man would have said, repent. Don't go to battle this time. Just relax. You can go another time. It's time for you to seek the Lord. Most people want to do whatever they want to do. They don't care what God is saying. May God help us in Jesus' name. This is what I'm going to do. I don't care. I'm going to do it. Whatever it's going to be, it's going to be. I'm going to do it. That is very, very dangerous. May God help us in Jesus' name. Then, Zedekiah, son of Kenana, walked up to him in Micaiah and slapped him across the face. Since when did the Spirit of the Lord lead me to speak to you? He demanded. You see, they have this pastor. Oh, don't listen to Pastor Masha. He's not the only one that is serving God. We're all serving God. No, we're not serving the same God. No. That's not true. We're not serving the same God. This Zedekiah slapped Micaiah and said, we're all serving the same God. And Micaiah replied, You will find out soon enough when you are trying to hide in some secret room. You see, we're not all serving the same God. When God is talking to me, he's telling me the truth. You may be listening to Satan, who will be telling a different story, because that's who you belong to, because you are serving the God of your belly. Arrest him, the king of Israel ordered. Take him to Ammon, the governor of the city, and to my son Joash. Give them this order from the king. Put this man in prison and feed him nothing but bread and water until I return safely from the battle. You see, when you say he put the truth, they're angry with you. He said, oh, that man is stupid. Beat him. Curse him. They started telling, oh, which are the man of God? You're not the man of God. Be very careful. We're not all men of God. I tell you, I say, as Jesus is who I am in this world. But Micaiah replied, if you return safely, it means that the Lord had not spoken through me. Then he added to those standing around, everyone, mark my words. Wow. I said that sometime when people really upset me. I say, this is what I said, mark my word. If it doesn't come to pass, then I'm not a man of God. This man say, if this man go to battle and come back safely, if he come back safely, you know, God has not spoken through me. Let your heart be in God. It's our heart God is looking at. Your heart. Is your heart in God? Are you truly serving the Lord? Do you have the fear of God? But because he said that, he said, put him in prison. I will come back safely. So King Ahab of Israel and King Jehoshaphat of Judah led their armies against Ramoth Gilead. The king of Israel said to Jehoshaphat, as you go into battle, I will disguise myself so no one will recognize me, but you will wear your royal robes. So the king of Israel disguised himself and they went into battle. Meanwhile, the king of Aram had issued these orders to his 32 chariot commanders. Attack only the king of Israel. Don't bother with anyone else. So when the Aramean chariot commanders saw Jehoshaphat in his royal robes, they went after him. "There is the king of Israel," they shouted. But when Jehoshaphat called out, the chariot commander realized that he was not the king of Israel, and they stopped chasing him. May God help us in Jesus' name. There are people who want to use you for so many things, who want to kill you, who want to use your blood, who want to use your head, who want to kill you. You see, King Ahab wanted to Jehoshaphat to die in his place. He said, "You put on your royal robe. I'm going to disguise myself." Does your friend say, "Let us go to party"? When you go there, say, "You drink." They don't drink. When you are driving home, say, "You drive." When you are coming, have an accident. Those people have died. But remember King Aram? That was the guy, that was the king Ahab said, "It's my brother." 3 years ago, there was war. God allowed Ahab to defeat them twice. And the man came and was begging. "So I'm sorry. I want to fight with you." The man said, "You're my brother. Just go back home." And God was very upset. He said, "Because you allow this man to go free, you are going to die." You have to know how to deal with your enemy. That's what they are praying. "God, I'm a worm. I'm a rat." I'm not a worm. I'm not a rat. If you're a woman, you're a rat. That's who you are. I'm created in God's image. Because I'm created in God's image, I'm able to stand and proclaim God's name. But Ahab made a stupid mistake. If he has killed King Aram that time, this world would not have been here today. But because he thinks he was smart, you know, there are people you make friends with. Tell them becoming a blessing to you, to become a cause. We call it enemy friend. This guy, King Aram, is enemy friend. He allowed the man to go. Now the man is coming to kill him. An Aramean soldier, however, randomly shot an arrow at the Israelite troops and hit the king of Israel between the joint of his armor. "Then turn the horses and get me out of here." Ahab groaned to the giver of his chariot, to the driver of his chariot, and badly wounded. Remember what Michaiah said? "If you go to battle and come back, the Lord have not spoken through me." Now he was trying to disguise himself like an ordinary person. He was thinking, "Oh, nobody will know who I am." Guess what? Somebody just threw the arrow, because that spirit of God that was going to make sure Ahab died is in charge. May God help us in Jesus' name. So you find that spirit of God who was in charge still had to make sure this man who think he was wise. You cannot deceive God. You cannot hide. "You may hide it from me. Oh, yes. You may hide it from everybody. Oh, yes. But you cannot hide it from God." Brothers and sisters, you may hide your sin from me. You may hide your cheating, your lying, your evil thing. The Bible says the soul that sinned, he shall die. I will help you if you repent and turn to God so that God can bless you. When I mean blessing, I'm not talking about physical blessing, because if you only have a physical blessing, this was not a whole lot of billionaires who are dying in America today, but they never know God. They had the money, but never had peace. One of them was Jeff Epstein. May God help us in Jesus' name. The battle raged on all day, all that day, and the king remained prop in his chariot facing the Aramean. The blood from his wound ran down to the floor of his chariot, and as evening arrived, he died. Just as the sun was setting, the cry ran through the troops. "We are done. Run for your lives. Because the king is dead. That was only what the king of Aramea demanded. So the king died, and his body was taken to the Samaria and buried there. Then his chariot was washed beside the pool of the Samaria, and dog came and licked his blood at the place where the prostitutes bathed, just as the Lord had promised. You see, may God help us in Jesus' name. You see the lesson here? When God, you know, God said some few years ago, he said, "Ahab will die. If he died, the dog will eat him. Now, the prophecy has been fulfilled. Brothers and sisters, fear the Lord. Do God's will. Obey him. May God help us in Jesus' name. The rest out of event in Ahab's reign and everything he did, including the story of the ivory palace and the town he built, are recorded in the book of the Chronicle of the King of Israel. So Ahab died, and his son, Hezekiah, became the next king. May God help us in Jesus' name. Remember that guy who prophesied? Micaiah, Imala, the son of Imala. The guy says, if you come back from the battle, you know I'm not the one. God has not spoken through me. All the 400 prophets, now what happened? How many times have they stayed in your country? All these pastors. Oh, the country is going to be all right. All this called Jew. Everything is going to be okay. God has spoken through me. But this coronavirus now, how come God has not spoken through them? Because they don't know God. If you know God, God will speak through you. And will speak, and will speak, and you will hear his voice. Jesus said, I know my sheep, and they hear my voice. And the voice of his finger will do not follow. May God, may we hear the voice of God always. May we follow God in Jesus' name. So Joseph ruled in Judah. Joseph, son of Esau, began to rule over Judah. Judah in the fourth year of King Ahab reigned in Israel. Joseph was 35 years old when he became king, and he reigned in Jerusalem 35 years. His mother was Azubah, the daughter of Shihai. Joseph was a good man, was a good king, following the example of his father Esau. He did what was pleasing in the Lord's sight. During his reign, however, he failed to remove all the pagan shrines, and the people still worship. The people still offer sacrifices and burn incense there. And Joseph also made peace with the king of Israel. You see, you have to be very careful what you do. Don't follow the God of your fathers. Don't worship the idol. You must get rid of them. That was the only thing this guy was not good at doing. The rest of the act, the rest of the event in Joseph's reign, the extent of his power, and the war he waged are recorded in the books of the history of the king of Israel. He banished from the land the rest of the male and female prostitutes who still continue their practices from the day of his father Esau. His father was a compromising guy. He allowed the prostitute to be there, but this guy said, oh no, you guys cannot continue. May God help us in Jesus' name. We must be able to make a decision that we're going to serve the Lord no matter the cost. And we must obey him, must do his will. That's where the blessing comes. There was no king in Edom at that time, only a deputy. Joseph, we need a king in our life. If you don't have a king, your home will be disarray. Your marriage will be disarray. Your school, your business, everything you are doing, you need a king. And that king is Jesus, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Invite him into your life. Let him be your king. If you don't have a king, only a deputy, your family is not going to work. This America is a very tough country. The black Americans are going through tough time because there is no king in their life. A man is supposed to be the head of his family. But because of financial condition, the women have taken over, and see what is going on today. May God help us in Jesus' name. Joseph also built a ship, a fleet of ship, a trading ship, to sail to Ophrah for gold. But the ship never set sail, for they met with disaster in their home port of Ezim-Geba. At one time, Ahazah, son of Ahab, had proposed to Joseph, let my men sail with your men in the ship. But Joseph refused the request. You have to know your friend. People that always cause you trouble, don't do business with them. Don't marry them. Don't be their friend. Joseph knew that he almost died by going to war with this boy's father, this new king's father. For that reason, he said, oh, no, I don't want to have no business with you. Even though we are friends, I know the essence of my friend, our friendship. You have to know the essence of those who you befriend. When they are calling you for bad things, don't go. When Joseph died, he was buried with his ancestors in the city of David. Then his son, Jotham, became the next king. Ahazah, son of Ahab, began to rule over Israel in the 17th year of King Josaphat's reign in Judah. He reigned in Samaria 2 years, but he did what was evil in the Lord's sight, following the example of his father and mother and the example of Jeroboam, the son of Nebat, who had led Israel to sin. He sat by and worshipped him, provoking the anger of the Lord, the God of Israel, just as his father had done. You see, you have to be very careful what you're doing. We hear generational curses and blessings. You see, Joseph, he followed the example of his father by being a good man. Here is Ahazah. He followed the example of his father by being a bad man. You have to know who you are following. Because your father served idol, you have to serve idol. Even if your father served idol, you can turn around and say, I'm not going to serve idol. then you become a godly family. That's a new generation you are starting. And all the curses that come with the bad generation of your father will never come near you. But if you now say, oh, that's our culture, that my father said something, I'm going to serve that thing, you're going to follow this, you're going to call it, you're going to call it the curse of your father and of your mother. You see here, he said, the son of Ahab, they follow the example of the father and the mother, and even of Jeroboam, and they were committing. May God to be angry. You know, God is angry with sin every day. May God give us the grace to do the right thing and to turn away from sin, that God will not be angry with us, in Jesus' name. Mm-hmm. Brothers and sisters, we're going to stop here today. Next week, we're going to start from 2 Kings, and I want you to join us. And as always, invite your friends and family to join us, and ask God to bless you as you listen to the word of God, as you do His will, in Jesus' name. Anybody have a prayer request? Let us pray in Jesus' name. Father God, I want to bless and magnify your holy name. Jehovah God, I want to give you all the glory, all the honor, all the praises, all adoration. Say, blessed be your name, Father God, in Jesus' name. Father, I want to thank you for your word we have received. Anyway, we have sinned against you, anyway, we have sinned by who we associate with, by what we do or fail to do, and I have mercy upon us in Jesus' name. Your word says, if we serve you indeed, you will bless our bread and water and take away sin and nothing cast on your day for people. We live in this country, this environment right now, over the whole world. We know the epidemic of this coronavirus. Father, your word says, if we serve you, you will never condemn our dwelling in Jesus' name. Father, may never condemn our dwelling in Jesus' name. We mean our brothers and sisters, our husband, our wife, our children, our family, even myself and all our partners who listen to this word by social media, that you bless them, uphold them, strengthen them. Father, bless this nation where Lord, and bless the nations of the earth of the world, where people hear your voice and do your Father, your word say, if we do your way, you will be a blessing to us and be enemy to our enemy. Father, honor your word in our life and bless us, and let your name be glorified, Jesus' name. Father, let's thank you for everything. Pray for the pastor, missionary, evangelist, workers of the ministry, that ask us for our prayers, we pray for. May your hand of blessing rest upon us. Deliver us from the evil one in Jesus' name. Brothers and sisters, the Lord bless you. May the Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. May you find favor of God and master come in contact with the Lord in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.